Okay, let's once again consider what happens to our open-circuited transmission line. Remember that our open-circuited voltage is going to be 2V0 plus times the cosine of beta Z, as shown right here. When you're at the load, that's where Z equals 0, you're at your highest value. Does that make sense? Well, certainly it does, because the voltage at the load, because the load is open-circuited, is going to be its largest possible value. Now what about the current? Do we expect any current to go through this open circuit? No, we don't. And right here at the load, it is 0, because this load is minus 2J V0 plus divided by Z0 times the sine of beta Z. Now what about ZOC? It's equal to minus J Z0 times the cotangent of beta L, and that's what's shown right here. So here's our open-circuited transmission line, and we can see that once again it can either be inductive or it can be capacitive. When it's positive, it's inductive. When it's negative, it's capacitive. But look what happens here. When you are at the load and moving away, it is capacitive first, not inductive, as it was in the case of a short circuit, and then it becomes inductive, followed by inductive and capacitive and inductive and capacitive. But once again, we can choose a specific length, like this, to be able to create a specific inductor, or a different specific length to be able to create a specific capacitor.